Mark Walker, let's talk about cycle lanes, an ongoing topical topic and nearly a saga in the city with a lot of passionate people for and against.
Yeah, exactly. Well, the latest, I spoke to the Green Party Council for the Regency Ward. Tom Drewitt is also on the Policy and Resources Committee, and we had a good discussion about cycle lanes. And from the Green Party's perspective, I mean, a lot of the cycle lanes you're seeing in and around our streets are actually not being implemented by the Greens as such. They were it was a former Labour administration under the leader Nancy Platts, and also more importantly the Conservative government, who have given the local council money and have then actually attached timelines and time frames in which that work in order to create cycle lanes has to be met. So there's kind of deadlines which the Green Party council are working by, and they're set by the government, and that's why you're seeing all of these cycle lanes.
So you're saying that the whole
around the city,
right? So the whole infrastructure is actually, we can't either blame or give credit to the Green Party alone. It's been set before.
And Councillor Tom Drewitt said that himself. You know, they'd actually like to get the credit because it is one of their policies. Of course, cycle lanes has always been something that the Green Party would like to see more of. But actually, it's really a bit of a longer story than that. It's, you know, it's the central government giving money to local councils. I mean, I was in Ipswich recently, and Ipswich has very similar cycle lanes on their main roads, and I know that other areas outside of our city do too. So it's more a government-led initiative and the government giving local councils money in order to create more space for cyclists and pedestrians so that everyone can socially distance. And
okay.
I think that message is getting lost, actually, in this debate.
Right. I mean, I think that the basic of it, you know, nobody would argue against the fact that it's healthy, you know, it's physical activity, it's being out in the open air, it's getting reduction in pollution, etc. I don't think anyone would argue about that. But there are a lot of people who are saying in town, is there not a bit of an overkill with those cycle lanes on you know, so many places? Is it really necessary to have added another one by the seafront? Is it really necessary to have narrowed the Old Shoreham Road? What did he think about that?
Well, exactly. I mean, that's been the criticism, because some of these cycle lanes clearly aren't being used that much. Thinking Old Shoreham Road, I mean, I've been along numerous times, I think yourself has, but it's not just us saying that. A lot of people are saying
that they're
not seeing enough cyclists using Old Shoreham Road. So the question is, you know, are they needed, as you say? And I think the Greens would say, well, time will tell. I mean, they've only just been put up the cycle lanes, but not through summer yet. Let's wait and see. Because as Tom Drewitt says himself, they're actually meant to be temporary,
right?
Including Old Shoreham and including Hove Lawn. So let's see what happens. You know, maybe they're monitoring the usage of these cycle lanes. I mean, the public certainly are, aren't they? And that's what's it's causing a lot of debate, is the fact that they're not widely used, or they don't seem to be widely used, at least some of them. So I think the Greens would say, well, wait and see, and they can assess the situation after the summer.
OK, so let's wait and see and catch up on this again.
Thanks.
Thanks.